You know, the road to success for these young dancers is a long one, and the time that you have to reap the rewards is relatively short in comparison. We're going to spend a couple of minutes talking with a couple of the dancers here who were born and raised in this academy and in this building and on this stage, and talk a little bit about their path from child to adolescent and training to trainee to dancing principal roles now in the company. Well, sitting here with Dustin Simmons and Bridget White, two of our dancers who are products of Ballet Pensacola, actually, and taking principal roles in this year's Nutcracker. And for both of them, the first time dancing these roles. I think what's interesting about this pair, although they're not dancing together, Dustin is dancing the Cavalier with Sugar Plum, and Bridget is Clara and dancing with Joey Mounce's Nutcracker Prince. But they both came to ballet and to us late in their careers. Were you 11?
Yes.
11, and you were 11.
11 as well.
Right. And especially for a girl, that's a little bit late. And I think what's been interesting about this particularly has been the track of finding these young talents a little late in life and accelerating the training as much as we could to get there and get them to this point. Tell me a little bit about what it was like for you as a student and then beginning to make that transition into being a professional, because both your parents are dancers.
Dance. Yes. Both my parents kind of had me already a little bit in ballroom and whatnot. I was still very, very nervous to come and take class for the first time with Richard, but it went better than I expected, I think. And the transition from being a student to a professional is a huge, huge change. You go from not sure what to do to knowing exactly what Richard wants. It's it's great. It's fun.
It was definitely a really difficult transition. I think everyone who goes from the academy into the professional company agrees that it's a very difficult transition because everything is just so different. You're looking at things so differently. But as a student, you know, as a student watching these girls grow up through the academy and watching these girls get to dance these principal roles, I mean, it was really cool because, you know, you're sitting there and you're thinking, oh, you know, when, you know, someday maybe if I try really hard, if I work hard, like that could be me, and they just do it and they make it so easy. And now being there, it's like, none of this is easy. If anything, it is 10 times harder than you ever imagined it to be, but knowing that you've earned your spot there is also really gratifying, and I think that a lot of that obviously is contributed to Richard and Christine's teaching and growing up with the academy.
As a director, probably one of the most gratifying things is to watch the remarkable work that Christine Duhon does in the academy, building the programs that turn these young people into these exceptional artists. Well, you know, Christine does such a remarkable job, and we have sort of a unique style and a unique flavor here because virtually all of the choreography belongs to me or Christine. And so the dancers who come out of the academy have a tremendous advantage because they really understand the vibe, they understand that feeling, and you both have been other places training. Talk to us a little bit about what it's like when you go away as opposed to here, because that experience is again,
absolutely,
is different.
With going, I would say transitioning from any one school to another for a summer program or even for a job, there's always gonna be things that their director or their dancers that they prefer over some things. So certain technical things, I mean, I remember the first couple weeks at Ballet Austin, the first week I spent changing my technique to make it suited to how, really to make it suited from how I was trained a certain way to, okay, and they accept it too, you know, they know, they say, we know you may not have been trained this way, we know this is, we're asking different things of you, but we want you to try because this is more how we right. see our dancers right. and just how Ballet Pensacola is how, you know, you guys see your right. dancers. It's different no matter where you go, I would say.
It's always a good thing, though, to learn how people like their dancing, because it just makes you pretty well-rounded, so you can go from one style to another rather easy. It definitely it's hard at first to pick up what Ballet Austin wants versus what Richard would want, or what Richard would want versus what Ballet Austin wants.
Additionally, I think one of the things that's exciting for us is our audiences have been watching you guys for 8 or more years now, and they've watched you grow up. I think what is great is to reach a point where we know each other artistically well enough that there are those glorious unspoken moments. Like the other day, I was getting ready to explain something to Bridget about the snowpaw, and I was like, I want, and she went, I know.
I was like, oh, got it.
You know, and you've worked long enough together that you begin to understand that. You know, and those are the kinds of moments that, as a director and a choreographer, are so valuable, because the history definitively and positively affects each moment in the present. You know, for these dancers, it's not their dreams that they're pursuing. It's really a city's dreams, because this is a company that really is the voice of this community. And to have a dream to speak for your community is a pretty hefty dream. And we're awful proud to be part of helping these young people achieve that goal.